Hey, what is up, guys? Perfect in between here, and new loading frame hype. Today we're playing Opwash, and it's actually kind of appropriate, but I'm sick because it feels like my throat is decaying. So yes, Opwash is the horrific god of decay. He is a mind mage, and he brings a fair amount to the table. This is the first time I actually got to play Opwash. I'd messed around a bit with him in a practice game just to get a feel for him, but yeah, this was the first. This is like, I can't remember when this was recorded, but this definitely wasn't day one. And yeah, everyone just kept insta locking up Wash, and I never got him in assault, and it's just like, ah, oh well, I'll just do the video when I'm not, when I finally get to be up Wash. So, but yes, I've been sick for the last couple of days. You can probably still tell by my voice. Oh, Medusa. Ooh, you're lucky this time. And yeah, Ra, don't place here. You're lucky I've got no mana. Because otherwise, Wukong would not be enjoying the 3 I'm about to throw at him if I actually had fucking mana. Anyway, I'm gonna head home. I'm gonna leave with victory. That's his backing animation. I thought I needed to put that in once. It's a rain dance, but it's death. But yeah, it's probably appropriate that I'm very, very sick on a day that I'm commentating an Opwash game. I got a bunch of games recorded, and I was like, you know what, fuck it, I actually need to. There's no corpses there, Trio, why are you trying to make things explode? Yes, probably. Oh, you done goofed, Ra. You done goofed. You hit. Oh, yeah. There you go. Yeah, it's probably highly appropriate that I feel like I am decaying on a gay on a day I commentate the god of decay. But yeah. Oh, for escape. Downside with Opwash is that he has no escapes. And so your ultimate, what the fuck? Nice lag spike. So yeah, your ultimate is basically your zoning and escape tool, because that's a stacking slow. So let's talk about Opwash a bit. His one, you've seen it a couple of times. It's, I don't want to say his main lane clear, because his lane clear is fairly bad until you get the full combo going. But basically, you fire out corpses that slow and deal damage and will explode on the first target they hit. It's an extremely loud ability, which means that Opwash should never ever jungle ever. He's also very, very mana hungry. I'll take that Miasma Wukong. Just take that ticking damage. Yeah, so that's his one. His two, Corpse Explosion, will, you've seen it a couple times, it will have a radius around where it'll have a radius and then another set of radii, depending on if there are any corpses there. It does base damage. Oh fuck me. Got caught right by the Medusa ult. That wasn't fun. Yeah, it will deal base damage with just piss poor, and then it will deal extra damage depending on the amount of corpses there. His three, Fleeting Breath or something like that. Basically, you just throw a corpse out and it applies a miasma that does a dot and does extra dot if they're, depending on whether or not they're healing. So, yeah, them raw heals are working against them, really. He's very good in Arena, we found. Because of how huge his ult is and Arena just being one big team fight. He tends to control that a lot. He just zones everyone the fuck out. Unfortunately, he is very mana hungry. Yep, Nemesis. I'm trying to stack here. Yeah, and his passive is that ring up above his portrait. It's just two of his abilities drop corpses on the ground that you can pick up to regenerate some health and some mana. Which is why I am building Warlock Sash to get even more out of my passive. And I swear the hitboxes on these corpses are really, really weird. And there was a bit of lag in this game, so it's making the corpses even harder. Like, the corpses just randomly don't pick up sometimes, so yeah. But yeah, he's definitely late game. His early game is fairly weak. His lane clear is piss poor until at least level 4. So, yeah, people are going to be saying, well, he's a mage, you just got to go in mid lane. I actually think he works better in solo lane. I haven't actually tested it myself, nor have I seen anyone actually do it, but I think he'd be much better as a solo lane counterpick because of the miasma effect. Because a lot of the solo laners have healing components. They have sustain, that's what they're there for. So Hercules, being one of the most prominent solo laners ever, which annoys me greatly, because I'm not a fan of Hercules. That mitigate wounds, more like miasma. Okay. Who else in the solo lane? Chark. Rain dance? No, miasma dance. Just any of that. No one believes me as of yet, but maybe I'll do it. Maybe I'll take him in Conquest, see how I go. I'm generally bad at Conquest anyway, but solo lane is kind of my jam, so I'll try him in solo lane and see what happens. Or wait for someone else to prove me right, and I'll be like, yeah, I was right, told you bitches. Anyway, so how have you all been? I haven't been well, as I've said on numerous occasions. I've been playing all these games I'm about to upload, episodes 21 through to 26, I believe, were all played during a period where I was really quite sick. So, nope. I'll just slow this Wukong. See, like, the moment you ult, you just want to, like, get the... They just want to not be in your ult, because it's stacking slow. Oh, I didn't talk about his ultimate. His ultimate is empty the crypts, you've just seen it. It's the widest ult they've ever done. Oh, rah, get miasmed. Sorry for the silence there. I was coughing and I'm going to cut it out, and I'm running the fuck away. Nope. Yeah, it applies a stacking slow, so I think it's an 8% slow and can stack 8 times or something. Either way, it's a huge slow, but stacks is essentially what it is. But it's only on the corpses that you see actually moving during the ult, so those are the things that actually cause the slow, not being in the ult itself. It's a really good zoning tool. It's basically what you should be using for, not for damage, but in Conquest I can see it being used for just zoning and securing objectives. Oh god, that was dumb, and for some reason my ult didn't go off, I don't know why. Wukong, whoop, that's a decoy. Oh, nope, that was the real thing, apparently I got them both. You'll know. Another thing I love about Arpwash is all of his references and his in his lines. So he's got a Kel'Thuzad line. He's got a Sylvanas line. It's just a lot of World of Warcraft references. I actually didn't play World of Warcraft all that much. I never could. I didn't have a decent enough PC, and I didn't really want to pay the sub fee. That, and there's just so much content to it now. It's just like, it's going to be really difficult to get into. But I did play Warcraft 3, so Frozen Throne and Reign of Chaos. Fuck decoys, man. Wukong got a buff this patch, that's nice. I do enjoy Wukong, he can be played almost anywhere except for ADC. That's kind of his thing, I'll just dump my ult here. Oh, red buff. Gimme. But yeah, people are still kind of learning how to... Oh, you're fucked, Ra. I am fucked. Run, Pwash. What are you doing? Fucking corpses? That's great. It's great. Holy shit. My butt cheeks were clenched fairly tightly. But yeah, game's winding down. Oh, bitch. He's running away. What a cow. I don't even know what's going on. My Vegas is freezing up. Oh. But I wanted to see whether or not I got the nemesis behind me. It was on low health. God damn it, game. Here's his victory screen. I already uploaded his victory screen, but I love his victory screen. He's just like, not dead enough for me. Anyway, guys, that's Alpua. She's a lot of fun. High damage, late game. Fuck all, early game. Yeah. At least that's my initial assessment of the one game I've played. Anyway, I'll see you guys later.